Hello and welcome again to this series of RetroShare. This time we are going to show to prepare the system to share files anonymously and encrypted. So in order to do that, first we need to set up some configurations. This is a little cumbersome, but it's going to be improved in the next versions. So in order to do the setup, we're going to go to the preferences tab. And from the preference tab, we're going to go to the files section. And on the file section, we need to configure four things. The first thing that we need to configure is the incoming directory. The incoming directory is going to be the place where the files get copied after they are finished being received. This can happen when we download a file from someone, or when someone sends us a file through the chat or through any of the means that we have here. So for that, I will just define this as my downloads directory in my current computer. Next, the next thing that we need to do is to enable this auto check shared directories every 10 minutes option. This will allow the system to revisit all the directories that where we are sharing content to share the new files that we have added there on a regular basis. After that, and in order for us to be able to share files through the RetroShare network, we need to add a directory where we put content that we want to share. So for that, we click on this button, edit share button, and we will add a new directory. For by default, all the files that are downloaded are on the default directory, are shared. I will change this directory doing double click on my new downloads directory, and also I will add a new So we will add also the new folder, as we said, where I'm going to put the files that I want to share with others. So I will just add new, and I created a special directory that's called RetroShares in this case. And this will be a directory that will be shared through the RetroShare network. Notice that there is a difference between the upper option and the lower option. We have this magnifying glass that is expressing that the content that is going to be in that directory is going to be to be searchable through the network. On the other hand, the other directory shows that it can't be searched anonymously. The only difference between these is that if someone is looking for a file, a specific file, no matter where it is going to be it is started, the file will be shared. But if the file the person doesn't know the file but wants to search for it, for example, I want to search for a Linux distribution, so I will put Ubuntu, for example, as a search term, only the directories that come with a magnifying glass enabled will allow others to search for the content. If you don't have the magnifying glass, only with a direct link for a specific content in that directory will allow people to access the content. So now that we have the directory added, I will just apply and close, and that's it. We have everything set up for us to be able to share files. In the next episode, we will share you how all the ways that we have to share files with other people. Thank you, and see you soon.